This is Frank Gaylard from RadioPedia.org, and today we're going to look at spinal cord ependymomas. Ependymomas are the most common intramedullary tumour in adults, representing approximately 60% of all such tumours, with the remaining 40% being comprised of astrocytomas, gangliogliomas, lymphomas, metastases, and other rare entities. Ependymomas are divided into six histological subtypes, of which cellular is the most common. It's important to note that myxopapillary ependymomas, which are sometimes discussed under the ependymoma group, really represents a distinct entity in terms of radiology, as they occur in a different location, namely around the corda equina, with different demographics and different appearances, and as such it is best to consider these completely separate entities. Ependymomas of the spinal cord arise from the central canal, which is lined by ependyma. Their distribution along the cord is not even, with the majority being present within the cervical cord, and only a quarter being located within the thoracic cord. An additional quarter spans the cervicothoracic junction, and as such, approximately three quarters of ependymomas are located in the upper cord. As ependymomas arise from the central canal, it is not surprising that they are located centrally within the cord and expand the cord outward. One can readily see the relatively normal cord having been pushed to the periphery by a central high T2 signal heterogeneous mass, which represents the tumour. The morphology of ependymomas is best appreciated on sagittal images. It is composed of the tumour itself, located centrally within the cord, is often associated with an adjacent syrinx extending above and or below the tumour, and characteristically these lesions have a tendency to bleed, and as a result, hemosiderin staining at one or either end of the tumour is common. This is known as a hemosiderin cap, and although not pathognomonic, is certainly very suggestive of this entity. The appearances on different sequences is predictable. They are typically slightly hyperintense on T2 weighted imaging, essentially iso to slightly hypointense on T1, with usually relatively vivid contrast enhancement. You can learn more about spinal ependymomas on radiopedia.org. Spinal cord tumours is also available as a download from within the Radiopedia iOS app. Thanks, and catch you next time.